Hello students, in the last class we discussed about the occurrence of the inert gases and general properties. In this class we can study about the compounds of the noble gases. Before going to study of that compounds of noble gases, first we study the discovery of the noble gas compounds. Discovery, that is in the year 1969, Neil Bartlett, very most important scientist name is most important. In the year 1962, Neil Bartlett treated platinum hexafluoride, PTF6, platinum hexafluoride with oxygen molecule forms an ionic compound, of the formula O2 plus PTF6 minus. When platinum hexafluoride treated with oxygen forms an ionic compound of the type O2 plus PTF6 minus. This indicates that PTF6 oxidize O2 into O2 plus. PTF6 oxidize O2 into O2 plus. The ionization enthalpy, ionization potential of O2 is nearly 1175 kilojoule per mole. He compared the ionization enthalpy of the xenon. The ionization enthalpy of the xenon is found to be 1170 kilojoule per mole. The closest value of ionization enthalpy of xenon and oxygen, Bartlett passed the red vapors of platinum hexafluoride. To equal volume of the xenon. Forms the orange yellow crystals. Orange yellow crystalline solid called as the xenon hexafluoroplatinate 5. This is called as the Bartlett compound, are also called as the first noble gas compound. They can ask for one more. Name the first noble gas compound or Bartlett compound. That first noble gas compound is the xenon hexafluoroplatinate 5. How this first noble gas compound prepared means by passing red vapors of platinum hexafluoride to equal volume of xenon, then orange yellow crystalline solid of xenon hexafluoroplatinate 5 is formed. This is called as the Bartlett compound, also called as the first noble gas compound. They can ask either first noble gas compound or Bartlett compound, then you write this one, xenon, hexa, fluoro, platinate, 5, very most important for the 1 mark. The reaction for that preparation is PTF6, platinum hexafluoride, plus XE, xenon. Then the compound xenon hexafluoroplatinate formula is XE plus PTF6 minus. This is the formula of the first noble gas compound. Then you observe this one. This platinum hexafluoride, platinum hexafluoride oxidize xenon into xenon Xe plus. That is, that platinum hexafluoride accepts the electron from the xenon atom. That means platinum hexafluoride oxidized xenon into xenon Xe plus ion. Then after this discovery, number of xenon compounds have been synthesized. After the discovery of Bartley, that is xenon hexafluoroplatinate 5, number of xenon compounds have been synthesized with more electronegative elements like fluorine and oxygen. Then, compounds of krypton are few in number. Few krypton compounds like KrF2, krypton compound, also been synthesized. Krypton compounds are few in number. But helium, neon, and argon not forms any compound. They still were not synthesized the compounds of helium, neon and argon. Why? They can ask this question for 1 mark. Why helium, neon and argon not forms the compounds means? Because these elements, they have very high ionization enthalpy, ionization potential. Due to very high ionization enthalpy of the helium, neon and argon, still they not forms any compound. Only xenon forms the compound. Number of xenon compound have been synthesized. Why only xenon forms the number of compounds means? Due to its low ionization potential. We already discussed that ionization enthalpy decreases from helium to xenon. Xenon have very low ionization enthalpy, while helium has a high ionization enthalpy. Due to low ionization enthalpy of the xenon, it forms only number of compounds. But helium, neon and argon not forms any compound. Main reason is due to their high ionization enthalpy. In this concept, they can take 3 questions. One is, name the first noble gas compound or Bartlett compound. That is, answer is xenon hexa fluoro platinate 5. Or you can write the formula Xe plus PTF6 minus. If they ask, write the preparation of the Bartlett compound means PTF6, red vapors of platinum hexafluoride treated with equal volume of the xenon, then orange yellow crystals of Xe plus PTF6 minus is formed. Then next question is, why xenon compounds are large in number? Or they can ask like this, why among the noble gases only xenon forms the large number of compounds means? You have to write, due to its low ionization enthalpy. Then next question is, helium, neon and argon not forms any compound, give reason means? due to their high ionization enthalpy. You have to concentrate on these questions. Then you consider the preparation after the discovery of the Bartlett compound. We synthesize more number of the xenon compound. In our syllabus, we are considered 1-3 compound XeF2, XeF4, XeF6 preparation. Next, you consider the preparation of the xenon compounds. This xenon compound, xenon mainly forms the three binary fluorides, namely XeF2, XeF4, and XeF6. This can be prepared by direct reaction of xenon and fluorine under appropriate condition. For example, XeF plus F2. Then directly consider XeF2. All these preparations are considered for the one mark, completing the equations. That is under 673 Kelvin and 1 bar pressure. Or XeA plus 2F2. Then you consider XeF4. By observing these stoichiometric coefficients, directly you can get the product. If they are considered 1 mole of the fluorine, then XeF2. 2 moles of the F2, then XeF4. No need of remembering these conditions. That is under the RO mark 873 Kelvin and 7 bar pressure. Just you concentrate on the stoichiometric coefficient. If the xenon plus 3 moles of the fluorine, then that compound formed is XeF6. For this one, condition is 573 Kelvin and 60 to 70 bar. Just you remember the stoichiometric coefficient. If 1 mole of fluorine, XeF2. 2 moles of fluorine, XeF4. 3 moles of fluorine, then XeF6. Then XeF6 can also be prepared by treating XeF4 with O2F2. This O2F2, when treated with XeF4, forms the XeF6 and O2 under a temperature of 143 Kelvin. This is about the preparation of the xenon compound. Then next you consider the properties. Among the properties, they are mentioned that hydrolysis of the XeF2, F4 and F6. This XeF2 undergo hydrolysis that forms the xenon, very most important for the competitive, even for the one mark question. XeF2 on hydrolysis, that is 2 XeF2 plus 2H2O, that forms 2XeF plus 4HF plus O2. This is the XeF2 hydrolysis. Then XeF4 on hydrolysis, XeF4 on complete hydrolysis, it forms the XeO3, HF and O2. You have to remember all the products. XeF4 on hydrolysis, that is 6XeF4, 12H2O, 4XE, 2XeO3, 4HF, 24HF and 3O2. You have to remember all the products for the competitive exam. In board exam, they can give other byproducts. They can ask any one of the byproduct only. Then XeF6 on complete hydrolysis. These are all considered as the complete hydrolysis. XeF6 on complete hydrolysis, it can form XeO3 only and HF. XeO3 and HF. To balance this reaction, 3H2O, then 6HF. Then partial hydrolysis of the XeF6, only XeF6. Partial hydrolysis. XeF6 undergo partial hydrolysis, it forms the XeOF4. plus HF. And XeF6 forms the XeO2F2 plus HF based on that coefficients of the water. If only one H2O, it forms XeOF4 plus 2HF. If they use 2 moles of the H2O, then XeO2F2 plus 4HF. These are all very important one. XeF6 on complete hydrolysis, if they mention the complete hydrolysis, then the product is XeO3. In partial hydrolysis, again in partial hydrolysis, two reactions. 1 mole of H2O is used, then XeOF4 is the product formed. 2 moles of H2O used, then XeO2F2 is the product formed. Then, these xenon compounds, you concentrate on these reactions. These are helpful for the 1 mark. In xenon noble gases, they can take only 1 mark question. You have to concentrate whether the occurrence, general properties or the preparation, even the structure and uses. In all these concepts consisting of only 1 mark, you have to study word to word in detail. You have to concentrate on these reactions, practice the reaction. Then one more reaction is xenon fluorides reacts with fluoride ion acceptors. Xenon fluorides. If they reacts with fluoride ion acceptors, there are two reactions. If fluoride ion acceptors present, fluoride ion acceptors, then they form the cationic species. Cationic, that is positive charge. If the xenon fluorides reacts with fluoride ion donors. If the fluoride ion donors reacts with xenon fluoride, they form the anionic species. This is also important for the competitive exam. If the xenon fluorides reacts with the fluoride ion acceptors, then that forms the cationic species. If they reacts with fluoride ion donors, anionic species are formed. For that one, XeF2. If it reacts with PF5. Here PF5 is an acceptor. Then due to the presence of that acceptor, it will get an cationic species. That cationic species formula is XeF plus and PF6 minus. This acceptor converted into the anion. Xenon fluoride converted into the cation. Similarly, XeF4, then antimonic fluoride, SbF5. Then here antimonic fluoride also an acceptor, then that formula becomes XeF3 plus, cationic species, and SbF6 minus. Then XeF6, for F6 you can consider the fluoride ion donor. Here MF, the M may be any alkali metal like sodium, potassium, rubidium or cesium. These alkali fluorides, they are the donors. Then it forms an anionic species. The anionic species formula here is M plus and XeF7 minus. You have to concentrate on these reactions. This is about the chemical preparation and chemical properties. In the next class, we can study about the structures and uses of the xenon compounds. Very most important one.